Hello children, welcome back to 10th standard biology class. In the last class, we were discussing about the lesson heredity and evolution, and you know that heredity is the inheritance of parental characters by their offspring, and what are variations? Variations are the differences in the characteristics of offspring compared to their parents. And two important definitions you must remember, and we were discussing about the rules for inheritance of traits or characters, and Mendel's experiments we were discussing about. Now, in the last class, we have discussed that each trait is influenced by both maternal DNA and paternal DNA. Means each trait has two factors. May be of the same type or of different type. Factors may be the same or may be different. Now let us try to understand how the traits are inherited by Mendel's experiments. By understanding the results of Mendel's experiments, we can know the rules of inheritance of traits. Now let us consider one important experiment Mendel conducted is to formulate the laws of heredity, or it is monohybrid cross. I just started, I hope, in the last class, monohybrid cross. You know what is monohybrid cross? Mono means one. A cross between the two pea plants which differ in only one specific character. We have discussed in the last class some contrasting forms of characters Mendel selected in garden pea plants. He used garden pea plants for his experiments because he got some advantages from that. I have discussed that also in the last class. Means they can be easily grown. Garden pea plants can be easily grown both in the pots also and in the field also. And their growth period is very short. Means within a short period of time, large number of plants can be produced also. Not only that, they show contrasting forms of characters. I mentioned some of the characters, contrasting characters also. For example, height of the plant, if you consider, two contrasting forms are there, tall and short, available in pea plants. And even if you consider the color of the seed, again yellow and green, again the contrasting forms are available. Yellow colored seeds and seed coat color, if you consider, yellow and green contrasting forms are there. And not only that, if you consider the shape of the seed also, two contrasting forms are available in pea plants. One is round seeds and contrasting form is wrinkled seeds. The same way, color of the flower, if the trait is considered, two contrasting forms are violet flowers and white flowers. The same way, the position of the flower, if it is considered, flower may be axial or terminal, two contrasting forms. Not only that, pod, I have explained what is a pod in the last class. If you consider the shape of the pod, again two contrasting forms are available. One is inflated pod and deflated pod. So that number of contrasting forms of characters are available in garden pea plants. So he selected garden pea plants for his experiment. Now let us look into the monohybrid cross experiments and how the traits are expressed here, and what is dominant trait and what is recessive trait. Let us try to understand. Law of dominance he explained by this monohybrid cross experiments. So monohybrid cross means cross between two pea plants. A cross between two pea plants which differ in one specific trait or character. One specific character or trait. Now, height of the plant is a trait, color of the seed is a trait, like that it is character or trait. Now let us consider Mendel selected pure varieties of one specific character. He considered height of the plant for his experiments. Height of the plant. So which are the two contrasting forms here? Contrasting forms of this particular trait is contrasting forms, which are they? Tall and short. So Mendel selected pure varieties of tall plants and pure varieties of dwarf or short plants. By repeatedly conducting self-pollination for several generations, he obtained pure varieties of tall pea plants and pure varieties of short pea plants, and then continued his experiment. So now he considered one specific character, what it is? Height of the plant. Which are the two contrasting forms of height? Tall plant and short plant. He considered tall, as I said, each trait is influenced by two factors, one from paternal and maternal. Like that, there are two factors for each trait. So each trait has two factors. Means this tallness trait has two factors. Pure considered, so capital T. Two factors: tall plants, short plant considered, and the tallness factor. Capital T here, both the factors are for, because pure variety it is, so both the factors are tallness factors. And this is also pure variety, both the factors are shortness factors here. So small t, let us express small t. So now tallness factor is expressed by capital T, and shortness trait is expressed by small t. Now these parental plants, parental plants, he conducted cross pollination between tall plant and a short plant. Means here this parental plants produce gametes. As you know, during sexual reproduction, when the gametes are produced, what happens? The chromosome number will be reduced to half, I said. So half the number of chromosomes and DNA, amount of DNA is received by the gametes. So that if TT only, the gamete also receives. When two gametes unite, it doubles, so that the organism cannot be survived, or it cannot survive. So what happens? That is the advantage here. During means that problem I discussed in the previous chapter, the problem of doubling of chromosome number and DNA amount will be, how it is clear? It is by reduction in the number of chromosomes and half the amount of DNA the gametes receive. Means during, two types of cell division occurs, I said, meiotic division and mitotic division, or mitosis and meiosis. Mitosis occurs in body cells or somatic cells. There are two types of cells, I said, body cells and somatic cells. Increase in the number of body cells, their mitotic division takes place or mitosis takes place, and the same number of chromosomes and genetic material, DNA, same amount of DNA the daughter cells receive. That happens during growth time, repair of the body parts, etc. This mitosis cell division takes place. But during reproduction, meiosis takes place. Means during reproduction, male and female gametes are produced. So during the formation of gametes, meiosis cell division takes place, it is called reductional division, and the chromosome number will be reduced to half, and the amount of DNA also received by the gamete will be half the amount of DNA than the parent cell. So now the gametes produced will have the factor T now. So this is gametes. This is the parental plant, and this parental plant, tall plant, produces gametes with tallness factor, and this short plant produces gametes with shortness factor. Now he cross pollinates these. So what pollination is conducted? Cross pollination is conducted. Then look at here, what he expected, the F1 generation, when he conducted cross pollination between tall pea plant and short pea plant, what happened? He expected intermediate height or medium height plants, but for his surprise, all the plants, look at the gametes now, or the factors now, capital T and small t. Look at the factors. Now, look at the factors, capital T, small t. So, this capital T is the tallness factor, and small t represents the shortness factor. He expected this plant as intermediate plant. What type of plant he got? All plants generated in F1 generation were tall plants, and he called it F1 generation. F1 generation. Try to understand, when he cross-pollinated a tall pea plant with a dwarf or short pea plant, what happened? This plant produced gametes with tallness factor, and this plant produced gamete with shortness factor, and when they are cross-pollinated, the resulting plants had two factors here. One factor is tallness factor and the other one is shortness factor. He expected intermediate height plants, medium height plants. For his surprise, all plants produced were tall only. And he continued his experiment. He selected this F1 generation plants took these F1 generation plants and self-pollinated them. Self-pollinated the F1 generation plants to get F2 generation. So, when F1 generation plants, capital T, small t, all plants were tall, and he took these F1 generation plants and self-pollinated them. When he self-pollinated the F1 generation, he got F2 generation plants. F2 generation plants, what were the results? Or what was the result of this experiment? When he self-pollinated the F1 generation plants, seeds produced he had sown them, and he obtained F2 generation, and these plants produced the gametes capital T, small t. So which were the gametes produced by F1 generation plants? The gametes produced were the gamete with tallness factor also, and the gamete with shortness factor also. So that two types of gametes were produced, and when he self-pollinated them, let us write the checkerboard for this. Punnett square or checkerboard we call. Now let us write the gametes and the resulting plants by self-pollination. What type of plants were resulted? Let us see. Gametes are two types of gametes, capital T, small t, and capital T, small t. So that he self-pollinated F1 glands to get C capital T. Look at here, capital T and capital T, small t. Capital T, small t. Let us first write capital T only, small t. And now small t, small t. Now can you tell me how many tall plants produced and how many short plants produced? So for his surprise, even though in the F1 generation, short plants were not at all produced, all plants produced were tall only. But in F2 generation, when he self-pollinated the F1 plants to get F2 generation, he got 1/4 of the plants produced were short and remaining plants were tall. Means out of these 4 plants, now 3 plants were tall and 1 short. 3:1 ratio, he got the plants. 1/4 of the plants produced were short. So this tall plants 3, 1 short plant. So tall and short plants were produced in the ratio 3:1. And look at the combination of factors here. This is a pure tall plant, parental combination, pure tall. And look at this, it has tallness factor also and shortness factor also. But which trait is expressed here? Even though there is a shortness factor, it is not expressed. One tallness factor, capital T, is enough to make the plant tall. So this plant is also tall and this plant is also tall. And look at this, for the plant to become short, both the factors must be small t, small t. So this plant is short now. So tall and dwarf plants were produced in the ratio 3:1. Here another ratio you can see, children. If you observe the factors, look at here, here both the factors are same, tallness factors only, pure tall it is. How many such plants were produced? One pure tall. And look at these two plants. These two plants have both the factors, factor for tallness also, factor for shortness also. We call this heterozygous tall. This is homozygous tall, means both the factors are of the same type. But here one shortness factor, one tallness factor, the expressed trait is tallness here. So that we call, when the two factors are different, that we call heterozygous. So this is pure tall, same factors, tallness factors, and two heterozygous tall and one pure short again. Means look at here, two also shortness factors, homozygous short. So two parental varieties, capital T, parental variety, and small t, parental variety. And the two plants produced, even though they had shortness factor, this shortness trait is not expressed, tallness trait only is expressed. So what can you understand from this? One tallness factor is enough, means one capital T is enough to make the plant tall. But to make the plant short, both the factors must be shortness factors, small t, small t. And in the F1 generation, look at here, try to understand the law of dominance here. In the F1 generation, the plants produced, all plants are tall plants. Even though shortness factor is there, the plant is tall only. Means here, the even though shortness factor is there, it is not expressed. Tallness factor only is expressed. So now, which is the dominant trait here? Tallness is the dominant trait. So capital T, which is responsible for tallness trait, is dominant over the other one, which is not expressed, is called recessive. So whichever pair of contrasting characters you consider, is which one, which trait gets expressed in the F1 generation, that is called dominant trait and which is not expressed is called the recessive trait. Now the expressed trait in F1 generation is tallness trait. T means tallness. Trait is expressed. So tallness trait is dominant over the other one which is not expressed. So this is shortness trait which is not expressed. Not expressed. Which is called recessive trait. Or which is called recessive. So tallness and recessive. So in F1 generation, tallness is dominant over recessive. So whichever pair of contrasting forms of characters considered also, the result will be the same. The trait which is expressed in F1 generation is dominant and which is not expressed in F1 generation is recessive trait. But that trait is expressed in the next generation. He got the results when he conducted self-pollination in F1 generation. He took F1 generation plants and self-pollinated them, and seeds produced he had sown and got F2 generation. That plants produced two types of gametes. Gametes with tallness factor, gametes with shortness factor. He conducted self-pollination. We write this square what we write here to write the results of F2 generation is called Punnett square. Punnett square or checkerboard. It is also called checkerboard. So we can write it for F2 generation. So in the F2 generation, he got tall and short plants in the ratio 3:1. And if you observe the factors, you will see the pure tall means both the factors are for tallness. Homozygous tall parental combination. This is heterozygous tall means it consists of two different factors. One for tallness, one for shortness. But the expressed character is tallness here. So such two plants, heterozygous tall plants produced and one pure short plants, small t. So in the ratio 3:1 means what? 1/4 of the plants produced in F2 generation were short and the remaining plants were tall. So you can understand that dominant trait means the trait which is expressed in the F1 generation is dominant over recessive trait. This is called law of dominance. So when a pair of contrasting forms of characters, plants with a pair of contrasting forms of characters are crossbred, the one which is expressed in the F1 generation is dominant over the other one which is not expressed, which is called recessive. This law is called law of dominance. I hope you have understood how the tallness factor is inherited and how the shortness factor is inherited. Now let us try to understand another experiment, dihybrid cross experiment conducted by taking two specific characters or traits. Means what can you define now? What is a dihybrid cross? Dihybrid cross means a cross between the two pea plants which differ in two specific characters. For here only in monohybrid cross, only one specific character is considered. If you consider dihybrid cross, two specific characters are considered. So what is meant by dihybrid cross? For example, say if we consider both color of the seed, one specific character, color of the seed, and the other specific character is shape of the seed. Shape of the seed. Two specific characters now. Shape of the seed and the color of the seed. So two specific characters are considered and each specific character has two contrasting forms. shape of the seeds may be round or wrinkled. Wrinkled. And if you consider this specific character, color of the seed, again this has two contrasting forms. Which one? Yellow and green. Now, how many pairs of contrasting forms of characters? Two. One pair, another pair. Two pairs of contrasting forms of characters. P plants with two pairs of contrasting characters are considered and conducted the experiments. How he got the result and the new combinations, how these new combinations are formed, let us try to learn. And just let us write now the factors for roundness. Capital R, capital R. And for wrinkledness, small r, small r. And for yellow, capital Y, capital Y. And for wrinkledness, small y, small y. So that, as I said, each trait has two factors. Now, if two pairs of contrasting forms of characters are considered, round, yellow, and green, wrinkled. So, which two plants he considered? Round, yellow, green, wrinkled plants he considered. Now, can you write the plant with these factors now? Round, yellow plants and green, wrinkled plants. What are the factors for round, yellow? As I said, capital R for roundness. And capital Y for yellow seeds. And can you write, please, this is now the small letters of all these must be considered. For wrinkledness, small r, small r. And for green, small y. You can't write GG here. It is just here already we considered. Dominant character Y, capital Y, recessive will be taken. The small letters of the alphabet will be taken. So now the round yellow plants are capital R, capital R, capital Y, capital Y. And green wrinkled plants are small r and Y, Y. And he cross-pollinated them and got the results. Let us write the results in the next class. Thank you.